Eucharist. Let us join together now and pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Friends gathered together as God's family, let us begin our Eucharist by asking for God's mercy and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him,
and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by name, giving you a title though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speech. They sent their disciples to him with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man, and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. And you are not concerned with anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this, and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." At that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We also welcome to our celebration today, as we do every other week or so, the members of our both confirmation class and the pre-confirmation grades 8 and 9 and their families. Very happy to have all of you with us for this celebration. And just a reminder to you that following the Mass, both grades, both pre-confirmation and confirmation, are asked to go down into the church basement. We'll be serving pizza, and then we'll have a special guest doing the session this week. If you were to pull out a coin right now from your pocket, although I would prefer you pulled out a 20, there would be a certain image identifying it as legal currency in our country. As you know, a quarter holds the picture of our image of our first president, George Washington. The half dollar, I have to get that one in because we're from the Cape, President Kennedy. There's other features as well, including the name of our country and the motto, "E pluribus unum," Latin, for "out of many, one." Also, we have on a coin, "In God we trust." But I'll hold that one for another honor. Our coinage, just like our flag, are images which remind us of our great nation and the allegiances and the obligation that you and I should have towards this great country of ours. Jesus in the Gospel today also reminds his followers of the responsibilities that they have to the civil authorities, even though it was at the time the Roman occupation who governed them, and their obligation to pay taxes. Now, we don't want to get into a big debate at Mass today about taxation, whether it's too much or not enough. That's, again, another topic. But I think most of us would agree that all of us have a certain sense of responsibility to the government in supporting programs and activities that contribute to the building up of a peaceful and just society. Jesus, however, is quite clear today that there's another citizenship to which you and I belong and also have responsibility and own allegiance. And that's our citizenship as members of the kingdom of God. Through baptism, you and I became citizens of God's kingdom. And with that, we have a certain obligation and responsibility as citizens of this kingdom as well. Now, while coins are imprinted with images to remind us of our responsibility and obligation to our nation, I submit that there are images which surround us, which are imprinted with the image of God, and also remind us of our responsibility and obligation to Him. So here's a few. How about nature? You've seen the beautiful sunsets that we've had around here this week. Have you seen how beautiful it is at this time of year, less crowds, to go down by the water? Nature is just screaming with beauty. I've told you many times I try to go on a walk, hopefully every day, but not always, but I try. And I do that not just for exercise, as important as that is, but I do it because, for me, it's a form of prayer. Because when I am surrounded by the beauty of nature, I am surrounded by the images of God for me in my life. And it recalls me to show respect for this creation, which is God-given. Pope Francis wrote an encyclical on nature, and the name of it was Laudato Si, Praise. And in this he wrote, "Creation is a wonderful gift that God has given us. It speaks of God's love, His affection for us. Soil, water, mountains, everything is a caress of God. There is a mystical meaning found in a leaf, in a mountain trail, in a dewdrop." Then he goes on and says this, and this leads us to another image of God. He says, "The image of God is also seen in a poor person's face." Yes, the human being, the human person, is also imprinted with the image of God. We know that. The first book of the Bible, the book of Genesis, what did we hear? That man was made finished in the image and the likeness of God. And so the human being is also imprinted with God's image. Now imagine, when you think about it, God signs each one of us as a painter signs his artwork. Now imagine if we saw God's image imprinted on every human being, perhaps our look towards others would be different. Perhaps we would look at the elderly person, the person with addiction, the physically or the mentally challenged person, differently if we saw him or her as an image of God. Perhaps we would see differently the unborn baby in the womb, or perhaps even the death row inmate, if we tried to see the image of God even in them. Here's another thought about the image of God. How about time? We know the book of Ecclesiastes. There is a time for everything, a time to be born, a time to die. Who wrote that? The turtles? The birds. That's how we know that passage probably better than even the Bible. But how about time? If we saw God's image imprinted on time, perhaps we wouldn't waste as much on silly things, on petty arguments, on frivolous tasks, because we would see it as a gift from God, a gift to be embraced and celebrated. How about ourselves? If we saw God's image imprinted on our lives, I wonder if we would live our lives a little differently. Maybe not take them for granted anymore. Not waste our minds, our hearts, our bodies on things that bring about destruction rather than life. What allows us to see the image of God imprinted on the world of nature, on others, on time, on ourselves, on all things? I submit it's the gift of faith.
that enables us to see God's image in all things. And that's why faith is so important in our lives. And boy, I've tried to get this down to the young people that I have the privilege of teaching downstairs. I don't know if they think it's a privilege, but it's a privilege for me. That's the message I'm trying to bring across. Our lives are so different with faith because faith gives us a vision that the world cannot give. Faith helps us to see the image of God in all things. And when we have that image and we see that image, then we are responsible. We deepen our responsibility to give to God what is God's. Now, of course, the clearest and the sharpest of all the images of God, we know that, Christ. And that's why God sent his Son to us, to show us his face, to show us his love, to show us his mercy, to show us his forgiveness, and to help us to find him in our lives. One of the blessings that has entered into my life is a person by the name of Tom Booth. As a musician, as you know I am, music is one of those ways that I see God, that inspires me. And so Tom was gracious enough to come here all the way from Arizona, picked him up yesterday, only doing kind of 4 or 5 of these gigs a year now, and he graciously accepted my invitation to join us for the next few days here at St. Anthony's, beginning with a concert this afternoon. So I'd just like to call up Tom just for a few minutes to kind of prime the pump.
You're clapping, but I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, two homilies? No, this is not a homily. This is simply an invitation from me to you to attend your parish mission on Monday night and on Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. What on earth can I say to you, and especially the teenagers that I'm seeing that are at Mass? Fantastic. Young people at Mass. That's great. Something is happening here. I think I know what's happening here. This guy here, he is very open and inviting to people. And you are blessed. You are truly blessed. But anyway, what can I say to you this morning that would have you motivate you to come back to church Monday and Tuesday night? I mean, isn't Monday night football? No, they canceled it this week because I told them there's a parish mission, so they canceled it. I want to introduce myself just a little bit so that you might know who has come to honored to be with you, to pray with you, to learn from you, to sing with you. So I've been in ministry for, I think it's 32 years this year. I'm a husband, a father. When I was in high school, I was normal. I didn't think I'd be doing this. I had plans. I played football and basketball, and I had a band and a girlfriend. I didn't need this. Tell our Lord Jesus spoke to me in a very clear way and ruined my plans. Father Steve talks about that imprint, seeing Christ, knowing God in a leaf, in the cosmos, in the poor, in each other, and in ourselves. If you're a teenager, could you raise your hand? I just want to, go ahead. If the teens at the end of your age, I love teens, they're like this. No. Extend the hand, put them way up. Okay, awesome, all right, awesome. I get to hang out with you after Mass. I'm excited about that, and the pizza. Is there pizza?
Yes. Okay, good. I hope so.
We hope. I want to ask everybody, I have some of the teenagers raise their hands. I want to ask, is anybody here a sinner? If you're a... Wow.
There you go, a little bit.
My man knows himself.
Raise your hand, just in case, if you're a sinner. Let me see.
Oh, good. A church full of them. Right over here, I see the missus doing this. Raise them both. If you're a big sinner, both hands. Oh, come on, people. Okay. Now I'm relaxed. We're all sinners. They asked Pope Francis, who are you really? Who are you really? And he paused. He said, let me think for a moment. I'm a sinner. Yeah, that would best strike. Sinner just means human. Just means it means broken. It means we need God. We need God. That's all. The problem is when we pretend that we're not in need of God and that we're not who we are. So the mission is going to really focus on our true selves. Who are we really? How are we made? You know, we're made, we're created to know and love and serve God. So when we try to find the life outside of the way we're made, it just doesn't work. So, as a young man, I love music. I still love music. No longer a young man, but I still love music. And when I started working for the church and learning about this beautiful faith, I was not really raised a Catholic. But when I discovered this amazing gift of faith, I got asked to write songs. I wrote a song for the Pope's visit to the United States. And when the Pope, I'll never forget, Saint John Paul the Great came in, I was about here, when the Holy Father was about right there, you won't believe what happened. On Monday night, I'll share that. True story, it was a few years earlier, I'd asked, we're gonna meet Mother Teresa with this youth ministry program we were doing. We're gonna meet Mother Teresa. We want to give her a gift. Would you write a song for Mother Teresa? I'm praying, oh Lord, help me not to write a crummy song for Mother Teresa. So I wrote a song for her, sang it for her. There's a photo, right, I'm singing it. When I finished singing that song, what she said was life-changing. On Tuesday night, share that with you. True story. As we end, let me just ask if everybody just close your eyes. Just close your eyes for a moment. Just relax for just a minute. Inhale, gently exhale, and simply be. It's like on Seniors Eve, you talk about a leaf or a tree or creation gives glory to God just by being a tree, just by being a leaf. You and I give glory to God by being who we were meant to be. And God, I would suggest, is not out there somewhere, but in a very deep and beautiful and close and real place within each of us. Here I am, standing right beside you. Here I am. Do not be afraid. Here I am, waiting like a lover. I am here. Here I am. I invite each of you to the mission on Monday and Tuesday night, 7 p.m. And I also invite you to a concert today at 3 o'clock, right here. My friend Carl Hergesell, amazing musician, will join us. He played with Kenny Loggins last night, and today he'll be here. And I told him Kenny Loggins is the opening act for St. Anthony Parish. Hope to see you at 3 o'clock and at the mission. Thank you. Thank you.
Visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only.
church leaders, may they be faithful to the mission of teaching and preaching the gospel of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our legislators, may they preserve the right of all people to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are recovering from storms and wildfires, may God give them strength, open a new vision for rebuilding their lives, and give them the support which they need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, may our faith assist us in seeing the imprint of God's image in nature and in all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may they know the hope that is found in Christ Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon Tom Booth and Carl Hagsell this week. May the sharing of their music and ministry among us inspire us to rededicate our lives to Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the departed loved ones, may they one day share the promise of life eternal. And at this Mass, prayers are requested for the fifth anniversary of the death of Stephen J. Walsh. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pause to add our own personal intentions in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we ask all of our prayers in faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Here I am, do not be afraid.
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the
Church. Grant us, Lord, sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all of its wonder to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, St. Anthony, and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you. be with me, my Lord. When I'm in trouble and I don't know where to go, be with me, Lord. When I'm blind, when I cannot see, when all life's trouble sweeps over me, when I'm in darkness and all I see is me, that's when I need you, my Lord.
Thank you. to help us to worship God today. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. The Mass is ended.